by assuming that the pollution, the contamination was limited, when we are not absolutely sure. Since we started this campaign of sensitization, if everybody listened by not coughing and sneezing near other people, by not sitting too close to one another when the infected person has got no symptoms, and by not carelessly touching oneself in the soft parts, and by not shaking hands, etc., the cases that entered into the house would not have spread the disease. Those people who came would not have spread the disease if people were not behaving carelessly. The question, however, is, in quotes, did our people listen? Did they listen to our advice? Don't cough near other people. Don't touch yourself with unwashed hands. That's all that was required. But we are not sure that people listened. Because if they did that, then the virus would not spread, even if the people went into the population. Now, since we are not sure, that's why it is better not take any risks by being complacent and assuming that everybody took heed when many may have not taken heed. That is why we have decided to take additional measures as follows below. Measure one is to prohibit all people-to-people movement by everybody, including those using their private vehicles, border-borders, tuk-tukus, etc. Why? Two reasons. Number one, some private car owners have turned their cars into taxis, transporting the two people we had permitted, assuming that they would be members of one's family, when in fact they were passengers being charged an exorbitant fee of shillings 50,000 from Kampala to Jinja. Hence, the problem we were trying to cure of allowing the mixing of people from different sources was not being addressed. The big effort is to make sure that people from different sources don't mix, because they don't know who is suffering from what. And that's why they shouldn't mix. Instead, that problem was taking new forms. The people with private cars were now the new public transporters without licenses and facilitating the dangerous mixing in the process. Secondly, even more importantly, is that even if the private car owners had been disciplined and only moved around with only the two members of their families, still that movement would be dangerous because we do not know who has the virus now and who does not have, given the penetration of the imported cases into the society, short-lived though it may have been. The ban on the use of privately owned passenger vehicles will take effect from 2200 hours, which is 10 o'clock, Shahina Zekiro, Sawa Nya Zekiro, Sanne za usiku, today, the 30th of March 2020. I would have given the public time to adjust on more scientific, but on more scientific study, it was found that this would be a wrong policy. Why? A longer time would give people time to try and go to the villages. In so doing, they may transfer the very sickness we are trying to prevent. So please don't think that we are not considerate. We know all that, but we know human nature, how people behave. They may think they are running away from danger and going to the villages, to their homes, when in fact they are taking death to our people in the village. We would then not be curing anything. This freezing of movement will last 14 days from the 1st of April 2020. This time it is not Fool's Day, it is Wise Person's Day, the 1st of April. The second category of concentrations are the shopping malls, arcades, hardware shops, which gather a lot of people to sell and buy non-food items. These are suspended for 14 days, starting with the 1st of April, 2020. Number three, all the non-food shops, what some people call stores, because stores, I thought it was where you keep things. But now I'm being told that I don't know where they call shop, store, duka. For me, I knew a duka is shop. Bustoha is bustoha. That's what we call it in Ankole. But here in the town, that a shop is a store. So please, I'm talking about shops. Shops, what we call shops here. But I don't know where they say that store. Number three, all the non-food shops, in bracket stores, should also close. Only food shops, or stores as they call them, selling agricultural products or agricultural inputs, not only products but inputs, selling veterinary inputs, selling detergents and pharmaceuticals, medicine, should remain open. The Ministry of Health should work out SOPs for these shops. Many people should not be allowed to congregate there. Those are the shops of drugs and so on. Many people should not be allowed, should not allow a large number of people to congregate there and form lines for buying. But also look at home deliveries. With the modern phones, you may not have to go to the markets. You can order things and they bring them to you. Even using the modern, the ordinary phone like mine, because me, I don't have those Marriott phones, which they talk like human beings. For me, I still have the other cavity. But even my cavity, I can order for food. Say, you bring me here so that I don't have to move. Therefore, home deliveries should instead be encouraged by all this, than all these issues of market. Number four, the supermarkets should remain open, but with clear SOPs, standard operational procedures, that should restrict numbers that enter and leave the site at a given time, and the handling of trolleys within the supermarkets. A lot of people can be infected by handling the unsterilized trolleys within the supermarket. Number five, the established food markets in Kampala and other towns should continue to be open. The established food markets, these are food markets, in Kampala and other towns should continue to be open. However, two precautions must be observed. One, the distance of 4 meters to the front, to the left, to the right, and to the rear, between seller and buyer, and also between seller and seller, must be observed in all the markets. Secondly, the sellers must not go home during the 14 days. There is a big problem of people going to sleep in the mizigos, wherever they are staying, and then coming to work. Because you don't know where he slept, his residence, what is happening there. The visitors he has received, the neighbors, the bar this person went in, you don't know. And you have got all these people coming from different directions to one point and then going back. That's all right when there is no danger. But since there is an enemy in the house now, that's why we are saying, no, please. Instead of moving like that, coming in, going back, coming in, going back. If there is space, the factory owners can organize temporary camping, make tents, people sleep there, work, and go back to the temporary camp until 14 days. When we would have had time to hear what's happening to the people who interacted with the returnees from Dubai. They must arrange to stay near for that duration, for the duration of the 14 days. That movement between workplace to home and back is part of the problem. How are the people you left at home? And how do you move to work if there's no public transport? It is that mixing that we want to freeze. Between home, en route, and workplace. Be only in one place for 14 days, and we shall see what is happening. Now, if the factories cannot do this, then they should suspend production for 14 days. If they can't manage to implement this, then the logic is for them to suspend production for 2 weeks. saloons, lodges, and garages should also be shut for 14 days from the 1st of April 2020. Like the farms, we would like the factories to keep producing because that is the lifeblood of the country. However, the danger is in the working, in the workers going home and coming back. It is that daily movement that must be frozen. Let the factory owners arrange for crucial employees to camp around the factory area for the 14 days. If they cannot do that, let them suspend production for 14 days. Number 8, construction sites should continue if they can be able to encamp their workers for 14 days. Otherwise, they should suspend construction for the 14 days. Number 9, the essential services are, because we keep talking about the essential services, they are the medical, the veterinary, the telephones, the door-to-door delivery system, the banks, private security companies, cleaning services, garbage collection, fire brigade, petrol stations, water departments, and some KCCS staff should continue to operate. URA should also not close business on account of not paying taxes in these 14 days. Among the groups to continue operating is also UNRWA, the roads group. We need them. And the funeral services. The Prime Minister, the head of, and the Minister of Health can clarify these groups. They can clarify. The main point is that the main part of the government should suspend operations except some groups. I have read some, but if it is some I forgot, then the Prime Minister and the Minister of Health will clarify them. These employers should, however, see whether they can encamp some staff near the workplace for the 14 days, which is the preferred way, or else get a special exemption from the RDC with the concurrence of the district medical officer. Get permission to keep commuting between home and office. Number 10, cargo transport by train, by plane, by lorry, by pickup, by tuk-tukus, by boda-boda and bicycle within Uganda and between Uganda and the outside must continue, but only with minimum numbers, technically needed as follows. Cargo aircraft, only the crew. A lorry, not more than 3 persons, i.e. driver, tandboy, plus one other. This would be, as would be directed by the Ministry of Transport, working with the National Task Force on the coronavirus. They can continue to clarify this. Number 11. Gatherings of more than 5 persons are hereby prohibited. We have been talking of 10 people, but Some people are using the 10 people as something to joke with. So we need really to be strict. And that's why we are saying now 5, not more than 5. Number 12, except for cargo planes or cargo lorries or cargo pickups and trains, starting with the 31st of March 2020 at 1900 hours, which means saa moja ya usiku, there will be a curfew throughout the whole of Uganda. All other movements should stop except these cargo vehicles. Let people stay indoors in their homes except for the cargo transporters. The exemption of cargo transporters does not apply to the borders or tukutukus or bicycles in the curfew hours. We don't want pikipikis moving around during darkness. Those should only operate during the daylight hours. Number 13, in order to deal with some unavoidable health issues like mothers in childbirth or very sick people, permission can be sought from the RDC to use private transport to take such a person to hospital. Additionally, government vehicles that do not belong to UPDF, police, prisons, or wildlife authority will be pooled and deployed at the district health office, at the district health offices, including the divisions of Kampala, with their drivers staying in tented compounds, ready to help in those health emergencies. Those vehicles of the government would be under the command of the district medical officer. On account of this pandemic, some sectors of the economy are suffering, such as tourism industry, the entertainment industry, the transport industry, etc. However, as I said earlier, new opportunities are emerging in this misfortune. You have seen how the demand for sanitizers, for face masks, for bicycles, etc., has stimulated new industrial opportunities. Working with the IMF and the World Bank, we shall set up a fund in UDB to accelerate industrialization through import substitution and export promotion. You have seen how dangerous it is for Africa to excessively depend on imports from outside. This is the time to wake up. Number 15, we are going to discuss with the banks, with the electricity companies, and with the water companies in connection with the loans and bills many people have with these banks. It is not correct to disconnect water or electricity on account of non-payment during this time of shutdown, or to seize properties on account of the non-payment of loans. We shall discuss with those people at the banks and see how to guide you. 16, government workers should also stay at home for the 14 days, except for the army, the police, the health workers, the electricity, water and telephone workers, and some other that the Prime Minister will add on if you think they are necessary to add on. Even there, however, SOPs should be worked out for the soldiers, etc., that do not stay in the barracks. This problem of not staying near the workplace is something I've never supported. At one time I wanted to shift and stay in Rubiri when it was still a barracks. The army leader at that time pacified me by turning both Nakasero and Entebbe into barracks, including taking over Nsamizi Hill. People who do not stay in the barracks should either stay away for the duration of the shutdown or camp in the barracks so that they avoid this day-to-day movement. The families of the soldiers and the policemen should also be controlled moving in and out of the barracks. The senior people could look at suspending that type of mobile movement, and also the visitors should be suspended to the barracks. Otherwise, you can have a major outbreak in the barracks. The vehicles of the army, the police, ambulances, utilities vehicles, prisons, wildlife authority, etc., will continue to move on orders of the competent authorities of those departments. It should not be just a driver driving somehow. It must be on permission by the senior people. The government anti-coronavirus actions of stopping public transport and other measures have put the drivers and other people out of work. Besides, many of them live hand to mouth. They just earn a daily bread. Without those activities, especially in the towns, such people may not be able to buy food. The government, after properly identifying these people, will distribute food to them in the form of akawunga, of maize flour, beans, powdered milk, sugar, salt, etc. In the meantime, I direct the police to arrest the opportunistic and irresponsible politicians who try to distribute food for cheap popularity. Those are very dangerous to the health of the people. When you try to distribute food or money in such a situation, people gather around you. Many people can be infected in that process. It would therefore have caused the sickness or death of those people. Anybody involved in that effort would be arrested and charged with attempted murder. Well, that is the offense. Attempted murder, you wanted to kill people by infecting them with the virus. Today, Mr. Elumeru of Nigeria sent me $150,000. I would use it to buy maybe 3-4-wheel drive vehicles to use by the Minister of Health in this effort. Those trying to take patients to hospitals, there are also people who try to privately trying to take patients to hospitals must also stop because they spread the virus in the process because they don't know whom they are taking. They are not professional. They are just looking for cheap popularity. They cannot tell who should go where. If they have money, let them contribute it to the task force to use in a disciplined and safe way. If you say you have money, you want to contribute, bring it to the task force. It is headed by Dr. Rugunda. It includes Jenna Cheng and others. Bring that money so that it can be used in a planned way instead of you going to gather people who can then get infected in the process. In Mbale, The Chinese donated to me 2 four-wheel drive jeeps the other day, brand new. I donated them to the anti-corona fight task force. So you'll have vehicles from Erumeru, 5, 3 maybe. Then you have my 2, then you can have others who shall add on. On the issue of these people who try to play cheap politics with the distributing food and I don't know what, the other day I was in Karamoja, I was going to open the marble factory. First of all, we had to stop the villagers who wanted to come and be part of the rally. We said, please don't come. Just the leaders only came. And even when I was driving through Moroto, the people wanted me to stop and start talking to them. But I would be, because when I stop, they would gather. And when they gather, you don't know who is who. So you are really an enemy. When you hear a so-called leader, people are dying, we are looking for, you are doing politics, cheap popularity. You will be charged with attempted murder because you are trying to kill people. That is the offense. Yeah. Attempted murder, that's how you are gathering people whom you don't know. However, the crucial point is the stopping of the epidemic. I do not want us to lose millions of our vulnerable people to this wholly avoidable epidemic just on account of indiscipline. What is the indiscipline? As I said at the beginning, coughing or sneezing where there are other people, number one. Number two, not washing or sanitizing your hands regularly. And number three, touching yourself in the soft parts of the body with the unwashed hands, the soft parts being the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. And number three, congregating in numbers when science is telling us to avoid this wholly avoidable danger and disperse and do not congregate. There's a sheikh who sent me a portion from the Bible. I was surprised how the sheikh came to know the Bible. But it is from Isaiah chapter 26, verse 20. It says in quotes, "Go home, my people, and lock your doors. Hide yourselves for a little while until the Lord's anger has passed." I thank you, and I wish you good luck. Okay?
Uchelevu. Uja kuwe nangu tisonyi wako kuruwako akai semu. Oza uli Devin tu vya njauro mkulembeze guanga vya ze wabi ya yogedeko oregulo no uruwa uruwa lero simanyi mweyo jemulimu jakubena nganamu mtuwa endo oza za mwena yebi mkwebio